microbes as biocontrol agents. So first we should know about biocontrol agents. So what are biocontrol agents? The use of biological methods. The use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests is called biocontrol agents. So try to understand the definition. Biocontrol agents are nothing but the use of biological methods for controlling plant diseases and pests is called biocontrol agent. So we are using certain biological methods to control the plant diseases as well as pests. They are called as biocontrol agents. Now what is the purpose of using biocontrol agents? Here, in order to know the purpose of using biocontrol agents, first we should know about the diseases of plants which are caused by the pest, pathogen, insects, etc. See, when you observe during agricultural practices, so during agricultural practices, first the land will be prepared for cultivation, later seeds will be sown and plants will be obtained, later it will produce the yield. So, in agriculture, right from the preparation of land, it is threatened by the pest and pathogen. So, not only after obtaining plants, right from the preparation of land for cultivation, at that time only it is threatened with the pest as well as pathogens. Therefore, the crop plants must be given protection. How you will give protection for the crop plants? By killing or removing the pest and pathogen. The pest and pathogens are removed, the crop plants can be protected. Therefore, the crop plants must be given protection. Then how the crop plants will be protected? By the use of chemical pesticide. So in order to protect the crop plants, we are actually using the chemical pesticides. And when you use chemical pesticides, the chemical pesticides can able to reduce or decrease the growth of weeds. And then reduces the attack of pathogens and pests to the plant. And even they can able to kill the insects, worms, which are mainly feeding on the crop plants. So that is how the chemical pesticides will be working. But initially, the use of chemical pesticides are more advantageous as they are helping in order to control the pests and pathogens. But later on, the diseases will be continued. Initially, you are using chemical pesticides. We cannot see any diseases in plants because the pest and pathogens will be eliminated. But later on, if you are using the pesticides, the chemical pesticides, again and again, even if you are using chemical pesticides, the diseases will be continued. What may be the reason? It indicates that the pathogens and pests have been developed the resistant against those chemical pesticides. So this I have told you while explaining the antibiotics. If we are taking same type of antibiotics, the pathogen which is present in our body, it will obtain and it will develop resistance. Similarly, if you are using chemical pesticides again and again, the pathogens and pests, they will develop resistance. Then what you will do? So next you will take up more toxic chemical pesticides. As you are using the same type of chemical pesticides, the pathogens cannot be eliminated and disease will be continued. So that next you are using chemical pesticides which are more toxic and even they are biocidal. If they are biocidal, they are even harmful to other living organisms like animals, human beings, etc. So if you are using more toxic, generally while using chemical pesticides, they are sprayed over the plants. In order to control the pests and pathogens, the chemical pesticides are sprayed over the plants in the form of pesticides or insecticides. But there are more disadvantages of using chemical pesticides. Let us discuss what are the disadvantages of the pesticides and insecticides. Especially I am talking about the chemical pesticides and chemical insecticides. Yeah, what are the disadvantages? When we are using these chemical pesticides in a more quantity, so that increased use of chemical pesticides that usually causes environmental pollution. It causes air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, water pollution, as well as air pollution. That is what I said, it usually causes environmental pollution. And these are highly toxic, and these are, as I said, they are highly toxic. They are harmful to human beings as well as other animals. And most of the chemicals which causes many diseases in human beings, like dermatitis, allergic reactions, and many of them are carcinogenic in nature. And even so, these chemicals can enter into the food chain and causes diseases at various trophic levels. So this is food chain, trophic level, everything you will study in the chapter ecosystem. Let me give a simple example how it may causes diseases in different trophic levels. I will write a simple food chain, for example, grass. So this grass will be eaten by grasshopper, and this grasshopper is eaten by frog. So this is a simple food chain. Here each organism is considered as a trophic level. For example, grass is considered as a trophic level 1, grasshopper trophic level 2, and frog is trophic level 3. So this is a food chain. For example, if you spray the chemicals over the grass, you have sprayed the chemical pesticides over the grass. So when this grass is eaten by grasshopper, which means the chemicals will be transferred from this trophic level to this trophic level. Again, this grasshopper is eaten by frog, so that the chemicals will be entering into the next trophic level, so that in various trophic levels, the chemicals can cause diseases. That is one disadvantage. And if they are non-biodegradable insecticides and pesticides, they cause biomagnification. Biomagnification. So this biomagnification is nothing but the process of accumulation of toxins in cells and tissues with increased concentration through the food chain. Let me explain. So biomagnification, it is the process of accumulation of toxins in cells and tissues with increased concentration through food chain. Let me take this example only. So this is the food chain. As I said, the chemicals which are present on the grass, they will enter into the grasshopper. In the grasshopper, it will enter into the cells and tissues. The concentration will be increasing. Again, when the frog, when the grasshopper is eaten by frog, again the chemicals can enter into the cells and tissues of the frog. That accumulation of toxins in the cells and tissues is called as biomagnification. So these are various drawbacks or disadvantages of using chemical pesticides. That's why scientists have been discovered various biological controlling agents in order to control these pests and pathogens. You just think about that. In order to overcome from all these disadvantages, it is better to use biological control agents. Instead of using chemicals for controlling pests and pathogens, it is better to use the biological controlling agents for controlling the pests and pathogens. So here it is very, very important. We are not using chemical pesticides, we are using the biological controlling agents. And one more thing you should note down here is, we are not completely eradicating the pest or pathogen. For example, if any one of the pest is attacking the plant, a pest or pathogen, any one may be attacking the plant. So what we are doing by using these biological controlling agents is, we are not completely eradicating, we are keeping them at manageable levels. Because in order to population is increased so that one day the forest cannot be seen as the complete forest will be eaten by the deer, rabbit, etc. So that is one example I have given. So later, what are the changes you can observe? So as plant number is decreased, it causes global warming. So global warming can be increased, and even various other floods, tsunami, etc. Likewise, many natural disasters can even occur. So the main reason is you completely eradicated the tiger. So if you kept at a balancing level, if a tiger population is more, if you kill some tigers, leaving other tigers, so that can be balanced, and ecosystem can also be balanced. Likewise, here also, if you completely eradicate the pest or pathogen on the plant, see, some predator animals will be, predator birds or animals which will be feeding on those pests and pathogens. But if you completely eradicate them, those parasitic organisms cannot be surviving. That's why here, by using biological control agents, we are not completely eradicating, we are just keeping at a manageable levels. And here, which are the biological controlling agents we are using, they are mainly virus, bacteria, fungi or other insects we are using as biological control agents. So first, we will discuss about biopesticides. Biopesticides. So biopesticides are those biological organisms which are used to control the weeds, insects and other pathogens. So biopesticides are the biological controlling agents which are used to control the weeds, pathogens and other insects. And which are the biopesticides we are using here? Here the biopesticides are like virus, bacteria, fungus or other insects. So the familiar one is, so among these biopesticides, the familiar one is ladybird beetle. Ladybird beetle. You may have seen this ladybird beetle. Actually, it is a beetle with red and black markings. So this ladybird beetle, which is an insect, which mainly feeds on aphids. Aphids. So these aphids are the pests which are attacking the crop plants, so that the crop plants can be the crop plants growth will be decreased with the aphids. That's why these aphids, as they are the pest to the crop plants, that can be reduced by the use of ladybird beetle. So which is an insect that is a beetle with black and red markings that mainly feeds on aphids, so that it will be controlling the growth of aphids. That is one example. And other one, dragonfly. So this dragonfly you have seen most of the time as they will be moving in the air like a helicopter. So these are the dragonfly. So dragonflies are used to get the rid of mosquitoes. So dragonflies, they will be feeding on mosquitoes so that the mosquito growth can be decreased in detail. So this can be called as BT. You may have heard about BT cotton's BT butyl that I will tell you later. So this is a good biopesticide. And generally, the biopesticides are of two groups. One is bio herbicide.
Use another fungus called as alternaria.
by an insect called as Cactoblastis cactorum. Cactoblastis cactorum, it is one of the insect which can be feeding upon opuntia, so that the opuntia or cactus growth can be controlled. So try to remember here, biopesticides are mainly of two types, bioherbicides and bioinsecticides. Bioherbicides are those biological controlling agents which are used to control the growth of unwanted plants or weeds. And the first discovered herbicides are mycoherbicides. In that, most of the fungal species have called Phytophthora carnivora, the fungus which is used to control the growth of milkweed, vine, and citrus orchards. Later, the growth of Icornia can be inhibited or it can be controlled by Alternaria icornea. Similarly, the growth of Punchia can be reduced with the help of Cactoblastis cactorum. These are certain examples under bioherbicides. So this completes today's class. Here we have discussed what are biocontrol agents, what are the disadvantages of using chemical pesticides and insecticides, what is biomagnification, later biopesticides and examples, ladybird beetle, a common insect, dragonfly, Bacillus thuringiensis. So this Bacillus thuringiensis we will be discussing under bioinsecticides later, and bioherbicides. These are all very, very important. In the next class we will be discussing bioinsecticides and few more things. So now we will discuss few objective questions related to this class. Yes, see, first question, when a natural predator here is a living being, is applied on the other pathogen organism to control them. When a natural predator is applied on the other pathogen organism to control them, this process is called. Option A, artificial control. Option B, predation. Option C, biological control. Option D, natural selection. Here you know that it is biological control. I told you, an organism, it is used to control the growth of other organism, that is called pathogen. Here it is biological control. And next question, microbe used for biocontrol of pest butterfly caterpillar is? So which is the microbe is used for the control of butterfly caterpillar? Option A, Saccharomyces. Option B, Bacillus thuringiensis. Option C, Streptococcus. Option D, Trichoderma. So here you know that Bacillus thuringiensis, which is used to control the butterfly caterpillars. Next, third one, which one of the following is not a bacterial herbicide? Option A, Pseudomonas species. Option B, Xanthomonas species. Option C, Fusarium species. Option D, Agrobacterium species. Here, option A, B, D, these three are bacteria species. But the option C, Fusarium species, it is actually a fungal species. So, option C is not a bacterial herbicide, but remaining three are bacterial herbicides only. So, that completes today's class. In the next class, we will discuss bioinsecticides as well as one more concept, bacillus thuringiensis.